Good morning. Today is the day for new tires. So I'm really excited. Camping here at the west side of Flathead Lake. Really nice campground. And gonna be stopping by Kalispell. Yeah, today is the day. Gonna be cruising and I'm excited to see how these more off-road terrain tires will be. So goodbye to the Michelins today. And here I am in Kalispell. It has really nice walking trails. So same template, you know, Home Depot, shopping center. And that's just, you know, what's going on these days. So, I mean, everywhere. This is a relatively like a smaller town, but it's the biggest town around, if you will. And overall, I like the vibe. I like the amenities, the overall atmosphere for the like bigger town. It's definitely nice for sure. Yeah, I remember off-roading when I, you know, during the early years of driving and always really liking these Goodyear Wranglers. Definitely a dream come true to just have them on this truck right here. Heck yeah, I think it's gonna be all set up for the winter. I'm totally stoked. Heck yeah, I decided to go with the stock size this time, you know, just to check them out, and I think it came out perfect. Looks just right. So I'm excited. We got traction now. This is Meridian and Idaho Street, October 2020. Discovered Flathead Industries. Looks like a thrift store. Definitely want to check it out. They also are putting in a really cool, this looks like a walking path. Right through here, so that's really nice. Just getting started up. All of this could be converted into, I mean, a nice little cozy something. I'm not too sure about hanging out around that though. So it was my favorite part of the town, just walking down Main Street. So we're in Kalispell, right off of Main Street and Center. Headed down to the Western Apparel Store. How it looks today, 2021. All these little walking paths are getting put in around here. There's the Triple Peak Snowflake tire rating. That'll make it a little bit easier going through the snow because you don't need to use chains, you know, as often. Definitely. So just got back to the campsite.
overall, I'm glad that I went with the stock tire size. I just like to keep things stock as much as possible. This is Flathead Lake. That's Goose Island over there. So it'll be a fun sup trip over there today to go explore that island. And then there's a little island over there too. It's kind of far there, but yeah, just for a little jaunt in the afternoon for dinner. Made it out to Goose Island. So here I am at the west side of Flathead State Park, and there are some gnarly trails that go straight down to the beach from this camp spot here at B10. I'm at B10 right now. So definitely a fun little morning sunrise, place to hang out. At the beach, but here the beach is rocky and very congested because it's right next to the cliffs that we're on, like a little bluff next to the lake. So definitely a great location, although just the trails are almost like rock climbing, but you have some good grippy soil. that's about all the relaxing I can do today. I'm excited. Gonna be headed out to Sophia's hot springs resort in Hot Springs, Montana. And as far as the lakeside, definitely looks like a great community right next to Blacktail Ski Resort. So I'm definitely interested in the areas surrounding the mountain here, even to the backside of Kela. It turned out to be just a great location at this campsite, great view. This is from Loop B. So this is a very friendly location for RV trailers specifically. And if you're even towing a trailer or a car with an RV, even like a motor coach, it's also a great location for that because there's a lot of turnouts. So when you're headed in, you know, and it's getting late, definitely a great resort to stop by. At this time of the year, it's October, and there are numerous walk-in or walk-up sites, and there is actually only one reservable site. So very, you know, quiet here. There's people camping all around me that showed up as well, and it's been serene overall. Just, yeah, nice, friendly, neighborly, and not too much interaction though at all. This is just a great location to explore. It's got trails nearby, great for a morning warm-up for the day, you know, just enjoying that sunrise. And you're really relatively close, within a half hour of Kalispell, within 45 minutes to Hot Springs. And great shopping in Kalispell. I mean, they're just, it's such a friendly town. And I'm still developing my overall feel for the city. I mean, I just know that it looks like they're putting in a lot more nice walking paths. And so it looks like they're gearing up, you know, for more growth in attracting people to walk around their stores, their main street, you know, and hang out. And I have some of my favorite stores there that I like to go to. Here at the Kalispell Center Mall, it's a nice little shopping center. Was able to pick up a ribeye pack of a total of, I think, 20 or so.
And they're just 4 ounce slices. So, you know, and they were going for $40. And these are all USDA choice, straight out of Illinois, out of the Midwest. So I definitely think that it's worth the grab. This will definitely fit in my freezer space. I'm just so stoked right now. And it was just like set up over here at this tent in the parking lot. Yeah, really cool guy get there. Well, I better get these back in the freezer. Head on back. All right, all packed up and ready to go to Sophia's hot springs in Hot Springs, Montana from here. Currently just having a great day. Picked up those steaks, which was a really good deal. And then got all ready to go. Gonna be headed out a little bit early for the checkout time, since it's at 1 p.m. I usually do a little inspection of the area just to make sure I didn't forget anything. So that's what I'm doing now. And got the rig all set up just the way I planned it, really. And it's nice to be able to say that. And also, a little bit of non-planning, definitely thanks to God for sure, for his provision. And like, I'm just like totally stoked, ready to drive on down and cruise south of here along the west side of the Flathead Lake. Over here at Sophia's Hot Spring Resort, monitoring my barbecue. Can just make out the temp through the video. We're at 133 and just waiting until just about 155, 160, something like that. Overall, it's definitely a great resort. It's got a hot spring in a jacuzzi tub. And also a bathhouse, laundry service, laundry. You have to do your own and bring your own coin, or you have to put coins in, I guess. Mary has some coins. Towed really good with the tires. I'm gonna go ahead and check out this town in Hot Springs. It's an RV, you know, destination. And there's also Rosie's Plunge next door, which is another hot spring. Oh, there's a doe walking right through the resort. At 140, definitely tempted to open it up to check it out. Although it's key to just maintain that heat. The Traeger is actually known for its ability to thoroughly and evenly cook. The heat distribution within the space is very precise.
And per some online information, you don't even need a rotisserie for these grills. The only reason I flip it is to get the grill marks. So.
Yeah, as I'm walking over to the hot springs, there's some deer here hanging out. Hey, does. They're in the path, so it's alright. I'm just gonna be walking by here. These are very friendly deer. At least the deer, like, I feel more comfortable around the deer than the dogs, really. Oh, there's a whole bunch of deer out here. This is funny. It's like so cool. Oh, there's a whole bunch of them just hanging out. Here's the composting bins. Hey, does, how you doing?
It's okay.
They're like, that's so cool. Right, here's the entrance. So here's the hot spring at Sophia's RV resort, and there's also rooms here too, and a house and stuff to rent. So it's definitely like kind of another creative business idea. They just ended up routing the spring directly into here, and then it just bubbles up and then goes through the overflow, so it's constantly refreshing. And the water here is typically, it can get up to like 117, I guess, from the spring. So it can be really hot. So it's been covered all night, and it is at, it's like at, I want to say 105. So it's a good 105. It was at 103.5 yesterday. And I guess it gets so hot that sometimes you gotta actually uncover it to let it just cool down, and the heat is like a thick heat. It's really nice. Has a little bit of that sulfur smell, since its source is thermal. So from my experience, I mean, that's relatively normal around here. This must be the content of the source. Yeah, there's good views though of the mountains, kind of. And then I could imagine on a clear night, it would be amazing. It's been like this all night. I checked it out last night, and there was some pockets where you could see the stars. Other than that, I mean, it's just, it's pretty cool. You can kind of see the fall colors from my view.
So from in here, the view is kind of, it's only the hilltop, so it's definitely a good setting.
Well, that was an amazing soak. I must say, gotta respect that heat that's out of there, that's for sure. Finished, it was around like 104, so it cooled off a few degrees. But just so enjoyable to wake up this way. Yeah, I just stopped in a little turnout right here. And so now I'm just chilling. It's towing really good. Overall, happy with the rig setup this year. And it's just like a whole bunch of fun, you know what I'm saying? Can't wait to get to the campground, Finley State Park. Here we come. Just got to Finley State Park on the southeast side. It's a point, actually, on a peninsula that just goes out towards the north side of the Flathead Lake. The Flathead Lake is really huge compared to other lakes here in the surrounding area. So yeah, I'm really excited. I'll go ahead and show you around the new campsite. Looks like somebody left a bag or something. Got electrical hookups. Yeah. And then just a great overall view right here on the shore. It's definitely stormy today. So, there's cool little islands that would be fun to paddle out to, but it is way too stormy today. Wow. Good morning. It is Monday in October, and I'm over here at the Flathead Lake Finley Point campground. Overall, it's got great spots right here by the lake. I'm a little bit fogged up. Moisture is definitely an issue, but if you can see, I guess, yeah, over there is the lake. I have a couple neighbors here camping with me. One's in a van and then one's in a trailer with an F-150. And yeah, just rocking out in the morning here, getting ready for the day, planning it out. And I've got a great drive ahead up north, and then we'll head west all the way over to Libby, and then northeast, you know, over to Eureka from there. So it's an exciting day because I'll be cruising through Kela, which is one little town that I wanted to check out.
And then also over to Libby. So Libby's another town that I wanted to check out too. So we have, basically, I've had a successful exploration of the area over the summer, to see and experience each town, city of interest, and go around in the surrounding area, find out what's there, what the local culture is like, and then in a more submersive way rather than true vacation style, where you're doing the tourist things. I'm just mainly camping out and then just doing the activities that I like to do, and then from there deciding, you know, what the area is like, or, you know, just that's what's fun too about exploring is you just don't know the overall personality, if you will, of the town or city. So yeah, I'm really excited. Just having some morning coffee. So we're in the business district loop in Polson, and one way of getting used to the local community is really just pressing the seek button on the radio and just finding out what kind of radio stations they have. So it's pretty cool. I'm gonna be cruising down 7th here. Following kind of like the main orange road. Just found a really awesome dog park that's located just on the edge of this little bluff above a portion of the river outlet of Flathead Lake. So this would be the Flathead River near the Polson Airport.
Our volunteers on the phone, or you can go online, mtpr.org. And you know, in the orchestral world, or chorus, or even opera, will say that, you know, that's the ultimate.
High as a mountain, love fun seems to be the ideal.
Rest stop at Lake McGregor. You can see the autumn colors coming in. It looks really nice. So just gonna be chilling here, quick snack, and back on the road towards Libby. All right, almost completed my camping journey and adventure, and stopping by the Rocky Gorge campground on the east side of the Coconusa. So I'm just walking around, check stuff out.
Oh, sweet. Dang. They have nice little campgrounds, ample parking. Definitely a good little weekend spot over here. Yeah. Well, no microwave, so I just decided to start up a little campfire and get these grilling. Ooh. Toasty quick. Already got a nice char on those. This is one of my favorite road snacks. Some ketchup and mustard, just keeping it simple. This is the view from the picnic table. Really nice view. Yeah, the setup, definitely feeling blessed for sure for this year. Just exploring with this. I just ran up the hill. Whew. That was a good little jaunt. Definitely cool to get out here and just have a little fire. I'm gonna put this out. Eventually here. Well, made it back safe and sound, and it's the morning of Tuesday. Returning. And within 1 weekend of camping, we got frost everywhere. Everywhere that frost can be, there is frost.